Hello, welcome to the 10-Minute Coding Challenge. This is a new segment that I'm starting here on The Coding Rainbow, where I'm given a programming problem, and I'm given 10 minutes to solve that problem, and when the timer goes, I've got to stop recording. So I'm not prepared for this, but normally I get a coding challenge from somebody, so insert person's Twitter handle here, wrote in and asked, how do you make a Starfield warp speed simulation visualization? So I'm going to do this in the processing programming environment. I will also make a P5.js version of it, but not in this 10 minutes, and I'm talking way too much. I got to get started programming. So the first thing I want to do, and I'm going to skip a few steps here that I might normally do just because I feel like I'm in a little bit of a hurry, and I see the clock. I already have a minute of starting. I haven't started programming yet. I'm going to make a, don't rename. I'm going to make a new tab here, and I'm going to call that tab star, because what I want to do is make a star class. And I want my star class, and I probably could use a p vector, but I'm not going to use a p vector at the moment. I want to have an x and a y and a z. And when I make a star object, I want to make, I want the x to have a random value between 0 and the width of the window, and y to have a random value between 0 and the height of the window. And truth of the matter is, for simplicity's sake, I wonder if anyone's going to watch this video on YouTube on like 2x speed, because this could be a 5-minute programming challenge. I'm already talking really fast, so when I talk really fast, it's the 5-minute blah, 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 blah. Okay, now I'm going to do void draw. And I'm going to say size 400, 400. So I want to have a window that's a square, so I don't have to worry about width versus height. And maybe we could figure that out later. But I need a random, and then I'm also going to make z some random value. Now you're kind of wondering, if I have an x and y and a z, shouldn't I be in 3D space? And probably I should be in 3D space to really create this Starfield simulator. But I'm going to try to do this in 2D, because eventually I want to port this to JavaScript and Canvas, and I don't want to deal with WebGL or 3D rendering. I just want to kind of create the illusion of stars moving quickly past my face. So let's keep going here. So now what I want to do is I want to make an array. And I could make an array list, because I want to add stars, and when they get off the screen, I'm going to remove them. But I'm going to do something simpler. I'm just going to have an array of stars. I'm going to put like 100 of them in there. Because I think what might make the most sense is when a star goes off the window to just reuse that same star in the array but reset its location back. And I'm going to say stars index I equals a new star. And then in draw, space is what color? The blackness of space, so I will make the black background. And I'm just going to say like update and draw, display, show. I'll just do show. So this is the basic outline of the program. I make a bunch of stars, I update them, and I show them. Now these functions don't exist yet, so I need to go back to my star object, and I need to say update. How am I doing on time? 6 minutes left. And I need to say show. And the main thing I want to do is fill 255, no stroke. I want to draw an ellipse at that x and y location, and I'm going to make that ellipse just like 8. And I'm going to run this and make sure this is working. Good. Okay, so I do see a bunch of things that look like they could be stars. Now I need to make them move. So they really should move, like they should move. I'm going to move this closer to myself. This is bad for me to start talking. I really just got to keep programming. But I want them to move like fanning out from the center, and as they go out to the center, I want them to go faster and faster. And that's what I'm going to use that z value for. I'm essentially going to divide. You could think of the ratio of their location from the center to the edge, and I want to divide by some value. So that value I'm dividing by is getting bigger and bigger, and they're moving out to the edge. I think this is going to work, and I saw an example like a year ago. I'm going to find that example and link to it in the video, because now I'm realizing this is kind of based on that. Anyway, I'll find it. Okay, but I can't talk about it too much right now because I only got 5 minutes left. So what I want to do is I want to say something like this. I want to say I'm going to make a new value called like sx, and I want to say x divided by z, and then I want to map that value, kind of like a ratio which goes between 0 and 1 to between 0 and the width. And I wanted to do the same thing for y divided by z, right? Because z, let's just pretend they're all starting really far away, right? So basically what I'm saying is that
I want them to start I almost shouldn't use Z. I just use the Z because I'm thinking of them as being closer or farther away. But I really want a value between 0 and 1. And let's run this again. And we should see it kind of looks the same. But now the difference is I could say here Z equals Z minus 1. And oh, you know what I've done here that's bad? Everything is happening according to the top left corner. This is a terrible, this is a problem. And we've got to correct this because I only got 4 minutes left. So I can translate in draw width divided by 2, height divided by 2. This makes a lot more sense because really what I want is to be translating to the, I want everything to be fanning out from the center, not the top left. So if I do this, you can see things are fanning out, but still from there. So all I need to do now is really think about this as like negative width to width and negative height to height. That should do well. And you can see here, and let the only 100 stars wasn't so many, so let's make 400. And you can see things are moving out from the center. And you can see as they move out, they start getting faster and faster and faster because I'm dividing by this number. Oops, and you can see them now. So they're coming back. They're getting sucked in back to the center. And I also divided by 0 because I got this infinity problem. So I need to do a couple things. Number one is I need to deal with the fact that when z gets down to 0, I want to reset z back to somewhere else. And also, let's have them all start at a random z. And then if z is, and let's just say less than 1, because I don't want to divide by 0, z should get a random, actually should just go all the way back. And you know, we could give them a new x and y also. And I could put this into another function. Now look at this. So now things are moving out, and you can see as they come back, they're reappearing. Now here's another thing I could do. First of all, let's make this whole thing bigger. And let's make more stars, just to be able to see more. So you can see how this is looking. Now that they're moving kind of slowly, so I also think that it would make a lot more sense for this to be like the number 10. And you can see, there we go. We're suddenly got something that's really starting to look like a star field, right? But the thing is, they're kind of like popping up. Like they just appear. So one thing I could do is also change their size, right? If they're farther away, they should be small. If they're closer, they should be big. So right now, the ellipse is always drawn at, oh my god, I only have 2 minutes left. The ellipse is always drawn at 8 pixels. So what I want to do is make another variable called r, and I want to map their z value, which goes between 0 and width, to when they're close being 0, they should be big, like 16. And when they're far away being width, I shouldn't be able to see them at all. And so now, if we do that, you can see they're far away, they're small, and as they come closer, they get bigger and bigger. Now this is like a star field, and let's just, by the way, let's make this really quickly, let's make this just like how z changes, a global variable, and let's be able to control that by the mouse. So I'm going to say, I'm going to add a variable called speed, and I'm going to say speed equals map the mouse x, which goes between 0 and width, to between 0 and, 20. So now I can control the speed, right? As I move the mouse over, I'm moving faster, I'm slowing down, I'm moving faster. I could eventually get to warp speed, and I've got 1 minute left, because I want to do one more thing. I want to see these streaking. I want to see lines streaking with 1 minute left, 59 seconds. So what do I need to do to have them streaking? Well, I want their current location, and I want their previous location. I want to connect those things with the line. So I'm actually going to make more variables. I'm going to say px and py, and I'm going to set those variables here to px equals sx, py equals sy, I want to also draw a line. Oh, I realize I'm going to have a problem, and I only have 26 seconds left. I can do this. Line px, py, sx, sy. So this is fine. You can see there's a problem, though, which is when they get to the edge, they're drawing, they're connecting a line to their previous locations. So So really what I should be doing is saying this. What the hell? I failed. Okay, whatever. So that was the 10-minute coding challenge. You should stop now. I this is really like so dramatic and exciting, and yet I totally failed. But I'm gonna give myself a bonus 2 minutes. Bonus 2 minutes to solve this problem. So I kind of was screwing around here because I was trying to be tricky and get the previous location, but really I don't want the previous, I need to keep track, right? Every time, the previous location when it starts should just be its x location. And the previous, and then each time after it moves and I draw it, then I should update its previous location. Then it gets its new location, but really what I want to do here for that line is say PSX, PSY, and it's not, oh my goodness, the X doesn't matter. This is the whole problem. It's the Z. All I care about is the previous Z. I knew something was going on here. I want previous Z. Boy, previous Z, because the Z is the only thing that's changing. Its X is like its position in the world. The Z is what's actually causing it to change. So I want PZ to start being previous Z to start at Z, and I want to draw, and then the whole point is, oh, and the camera goes off, and I have 54 seconds left. We're going to make this happen in my bonus 2 minutes. I'm gonna say here, float, PX equals, and this exact same formula, but now I want X divided by PZ. And PY, I want X divided by, Y divided by PZ. So now I'm drawing a line between the two locations. We don't care about this, although it's probably a good time here to give it its previous location also. Whoa, something lunacy is happening. What did I miss? I have 19 seconds left. X divided by PZ. Oh, height, no, but that shouldn't matter. Oh, X, here we go. So close. 6 seconds left. What did I miss? PX. Oh, SX. XX. SX. SY. Here we go. There we go. So you can see now, in all of its glory, the warp speed streakiness. Boy, it said 1 second there for a while because it doesn't actually say time expired until I click over here. Okay. Interestingly enough, something is definitely not working because... Ah, I forgot to say PZ equals Z. There we go. So you can see its streakiness. Let's make it go faster. I'm really failing with the 10-minute thing. We'll see how long this video is in the end. It can't be more than 15 minutes, otherwise I'll really feel like a total failure. I'm gonna turn off the ellipse for a second. And here we go. This is what I was sort of hoping to see. You can see the streaks as it draws the lines, and I can slow down, and I can put those circles back in there. There's all sorts of possibilities here. So I hope you enjoyed this video about how to make a star field. I'm also going to upload a JavaScript version of this that will run in the browser. The links to both the code for both of those will be in the description. If they're not there, write a comment reminding me. And I will see you in the next edition of 10-Minute Coding Challenge, which is just probably going to be 15 minutes. Tweet me with a challenge. I'll keep track of a list of them, and I will do it in the next time. Okay.